Hello, Sassy Lady. How are you feeling today? Thank you for joining me in the episode 67 of Little Fixers Podcast. तो आज के एपिसोड में बहुत सारे टेकअवेज होंगे कि हम कैसे लीप ऑफ फेथ लेके टफ टाइम्स में अपने काम को पिवट कर सकते हैं, कैसे चेंज कर सकते हैं और अपनी सिचुएशन के हिसाब से अपने आप को अडेप्ट कर सकते हैं और ग्रो कर सकते हैं. ऐसा कंटेंट हम कैसे क्रिएट कर सकते हैं जो हमारे ऑडियंस से कनेक्ट करे और हमारी कम्युनिटी को बिल्ड करने में हेल्प करे. ये सब चीजें टाइम लेती हैं, साथ ही ऑथेंटिक होना बहुत जरूरी है. आई कैन नॉट स्ट्रेस इट इनफ. सो आज के एपिसोड से जो भी आप सीखेंगे, सब कुछ आपके लाइफ में किसी ना किसी चीज में हेल्प जरूर करेगा. लेकिन ये सब कैसे हुआ, किसने किया, तो चलिए फिर पता करते हैं कि हमारा आज का गेस्ट कौन है और वो हमारे लिए क्या स्पेशल लेकर आई है. Hey there, welcome to Little Fixes, a podcast for the sassy, classy and a little choosy Bharatiya Nari. This is Maitri. मैं और मेरे गेस्ट शेयर करते हैं सिंपल प्रैक्टिकल आइडियाज जो आप इजीली फॉलो कर सकते हैं टू गेट क्लोजर टू द काइंड ऑफ लाइफ यू वांट टू लिव. वी टॉक अबाउट करियर, सेल्फ केयर, सोशल मीडिया टिप्स, पेरेंटिंग, रिलेशनशिप्स एंड सो मच मोर टू हेल्प यू थ्राइव. ऑल ऑफ दिस इज मिक्स्ड विद अ लॉट ऑफ लाफ्टर. सो माय लवली फ्रेंड, कंटिन्यू व्हाट यू आर डूइंग एंड जॉइन मी इन दिस रियल टॉक. ओके, सो लिटिल फिक्सेस पे आज मेरे साथ हैं शर्मिला पाटिल. हम लोग बात करने वाले हैं ऐसा कंटेंट हम कैसे क्रिएट करें कि हमारे फॉलोअर्स ग्रो हो, या फिर एक जो कोहेसिवनेस होती है हमारी फीड की वो कैसे मेंटेन करें, और स्टोरी टेलिंग के बारे में बात करने वाले हैं शर्मिला से. बिकॉज शर्मिला इज अ लाइफस्टाइल ब्लॉगर, शी इज अ फोटोग्राफर, शी इज अ प्रोडक्ट स्टाइलिस्ट, शी इज अ होम स्टाइलिस्ट एंड शी इज अ कैनन इन्फ्लुएंसर ऑल्सो. एंड इफ यू गो टू हर इंस्टाग्राम फीड, इंस्टाग्राम पेज विच इज सिंसियर स्टोरी टेलर, यू विल लव इट. यू विल सिंपली फॉल इन लव विद हर एस्थेटिक्स एंड एवरीथिंग. तो शी इज द राइट पर्सन टू टॉक अबाउट क्रिएटिंग द काइंड ऑफ कॉन्टेंट दैट ब्रिंग्स यू फॉलोअर्स. सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट टॉकिंग, लेट्स वेलकम शर्मिला ऑन लिटिल फिक्सेस. हाई शर्मिला, वी आर थ्रिल्ड टू हैव यू हियर.
Hi Maitri, thank you so, so much. This is my first podcast. Let me just start with that. So if there are any blunders, you have to forgive me.
Okay, no worries about that actually, because most of my guests had their first podcast with me.
Oh, see, so this is the perfect place to start.
yeah, why not? So Sharmila, as I introduced you as a photographer and a lifestyle blogger, so I would like to know a little bit more about your journey. My listeners would love to know ki how you started with this photography thing. Ki aap shuru se photographer the ya pehle kuch aur karte the, kaise aap isme aaye?
Okay, so I think every journey should have an interesting story, you know, like kahan chalu kiya and kahan you ended up. So by education, I am an electronics and telecommunication engineer. After I got married, I did landscape designing. So I think everything you do in life kind of gets you to a point where fate has decided you should be. So what happened with landscape designing was Photoshop was a part of our curriculum, because to handle your client presentations, you kind of need to click pictures a certain way and edit pictures a certain way. So the client kind of agrees to go ahead with you as the landscape designer. So Photoshop and basic photography was a part of our curriculum. So because of which, I'm so glad that, you know, I did Photoshop in depth. Like, it's not a course done from some online institution, or it's not YouTube videos. It's a proper exam that I had to give in Photoshop. So that kind of has been one of the biggest things I took away from landscaping. Because honestly, post that, I didn't do landscaping for too long. I kind of realized that once I picked up a camera, I kind of realized that, you know, I enjoy doing this. So initially I began as a children and family photographer, which I did for about 6 years, 7 years. I also have another page that has this. It's called Sincerely Sharmila. That's all of my children and family photography. And to be completely candid, Sincere Storyteller happened just last year. So last April, around the 10th of April was when Sincere Storyteller got to 10K, and that's when my journey began.
So in lockdown, photography, mostly.
Yes. So what happened was, before that, I was taking pictures of humans. I was taking pictures of people. And when we were locked down at home, there was only so long my husband and my child were going to let me take pictures of them. So I think after the first 4 days, we have a pet as well. His name is Bruno. There came a point where even Bruno would run away from me. He was like, we're all done. Like, they couldn't. And I think every artist, every creator needs a creative outlet.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when I turned my camera to other things. Like, maybe it was the food we were cooking. It was incessant food that all of us cooked in the lockdown.
Mm-hmm.
Like breakfast, lunch, dinner. So, you know, taking those pictures, or taking pictures of the home, the garden, because that was all I had at my disposal at that time.
Mm-hmm.
And Instagram just became an outlet of sharing what we were doing at home. Because honestly, till then, Instagram, for me personally, wasn't a form of business. Because Pune is a small city, and I was very happy work-wise with just word of mouth.
Mm-hmm.
So sincerely, Sharmila was only word of mouth. I never had to market. I never had to put up too much content. And so when I started putting up pictures of, say, home, or, you know, just our house in general, or food, or people started appreciating it.
Mm-hmm.
Mind you, that was not, I was still exploring. So if you go to last year's pictures and see the stark difference between last year and this year,
mm-hmm.
You're going to kind of follow me in my journey. Like, everybody who's been with me for the last 1 year kind of know I grew up as a photographer in the last year.
Mm-hmm.
Because the lockdown has been a big teacher. I have ended up doing about 11 courses and 7 follow-alongs. I have done courses in SEO, in optimizing Pinterest, optimizing Instagram. I think just because of everything shutting down offline, the online became such a wide source of knowledge for anybody wanting to learn.
Yes.
So, yeah, so honestly, I think it just, I happen to have capitalized on that a lot. And that's I think, how our journey began. And practice, I think showing up and consistency is the only thing that has helped me to go from a family of 10K to what, 44K today?
Mm-hmm. Wow.
So it's a journey of a year. And wow. So till then, I was at 8K for the longest time, and it didn't bother me because I didn't use Instagram as a business model. So that's my journey. That's how we started, and that's where we are today.
Wow. So you took what you had, you made the best of out of it, and now you have a business out of it. Like,
जो भी आपको मिला उसने कर लिया है ना, बेटर देन आई डू.
या मतलब ऐसे बहुत सारे लोग होते हैं जो सोचते रहते हैं कि यार ये अब बंद हो गया, अब हम क्या कर सकते हैं, अब क्या होगा. लाइक फॉर अ फोटोग्राफर, इनफैक्ट आई हर्ड अ लॉट ऑफ पॉडकास्ट अबाउट फोटोग्राफर्स गोइंग आउट ऑफ बिजनेस बिकॉज पीपल वर स्टक एट होम.
दैट्स ट्रू. टू फोटोग्राफी, दैट्स ट्रू. आई हैव सो मेनी फ्रेंड्स हु डिड.
Yeah, and still you turned it around, and you managed to create something out of it, and you are very successful at it. So this is incredible. This is also inspirational.
You know, kind of inspire people to take that leap of faith.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because probably if I would have just given up and sat at home, not only would I have been frustrated, mm-hmm. but also it kind of blocks you creatively. And I feel like people with a creative instinct always need to do something. Like, I think that's where anxiety and all these depression issues and all these other things come up.
Huh, that's true. Aapne bataya ki you became what you are in a period of 1 year. Mostly.
Yes.
So obviously our journey starts much earlier. और अगर किसी को बोलेंगे तो ये भी बोल सकते हैं कि अच्छा इन्होंने एक साल में सब अचीव कर लिया है, but no, it started way back. Like you were doing whatever you learned, whatever you did, everything
helped you. That's why I wanted to start at the beginning, because Photoshop, learning Photoshop, and you know, getting that camera for a different kind of career is what actually started me on this path. What you said is absolutely true, Maitri. People think कि एक साल में होंगे. But it's not just that. It's the amount of work you put in. So all these courses that I do online or did online, none of them are Indian. Because I don't know if you know, but all of these courses that are there, they're all Europeans and Americans.
Yeah.
So their course, if it's a follow-along, starts at 11:30 and 12:30 in the night.
Mm-hmm.
Because you're on their time. Mm-hmm. Unless it's recorded videos that you're watching.
Mm-hmm.
If it's a follow-along course, it starts at 12:30 in the night. So I would sit from 12:30 in the night to 3:30 sometimes in the morning for my course, and then do all the work you had to do next day because there was nobody coming to help you since it was locked up.
Yeah.
And I have a 4-year-old. So it's not, nothing comes easy. Like people think ek saal mein ho gaya. It's not like that.
हाँ वही मुझे, मैं यही सोच रही थी जैसे ना यू सेड कि 12:30 पे स्टार्ट होता था, आई वाज लाइक अच्छा शी यूज्ड टू स्टे अप फॉर दैट लेट। आई एम लाइक कि अगर मुझे 10 बजे 11 बजे सोने को नहीं मिला तो फिर आई विल स्लीप टिल 9, मुझसे नहीं हो पाएगा।
करेक्ट,
तो बट यू
बट फिर
डिड
भी
इट
सुबह
ना।
7:30 बजे तो उठना ही पड़ता है, बिकॉज माय लिटिल वन इज एन अर्ली राइजर, ही वेक्स अप समटाइम्स इवन बिफोर द बर्ड्स आर अप, सो इररिस्पेक्टिव वी हैड टू गेट अप इन द मॉर्निंग. So I think it's a little bit of everything. Of course, it's a little bit of chance, it's a little bit of faith, but it's a lot of what you decide to do with it. I think everybody is given an opportunity. What you do with the opportunity is up to you.
So Sharmila, what is your content creation process? अगर हम बिहाइंड द सीन की बात करें कि लाइक यू पुट अप पिक्चर्स, ब्यूटिफुल पिक्चर्स ऑफ योर होम, डिफरेंट कॉर्नर्स ऑफ योर होम, या फिर रील्स ऑफ डिफरेंट स्पॉट्स फ्रॉम योर होम, सो हाउ डू यू डिसाइड कि आज मुझे क्या शूट करना है, क्या डालना है? डू यू स्टार्ट विद कैप्शन की पहले कैप्शन सोच लिया कि इस कॉन्सेप्ट पे डालना है, या यू स्टार्ट विद अ कॉर्नर, या यू स्टार्ट विद अ कॉन्सेप्ट? मतलब वट एग्जैक्टली इज योर कॉन्टेंट क्रिएशन प्रोसेस?
Content creation is a very, very vast subject. It's not just what I post today or what I'm going to post tomorrow. For bloggers who do this, especially, okay, let me talk specifically to me. I am a product stylist and a product photographer, and I work with about 56 brands, big and small. So for me, it's also a lot about grid planning. So if I tell, say today is the 16th, and if I tell the brand, you know, I have to post, they said Monday ko chahiye post. So then I give them the date of 20th, which I have to mark on my calendar. Then there is another brand that says, you know, can you do it on a Thursday? Because we get traction better on a Thursday. So I jot down that brand on a Thursday. So now I'm at a point where every week I have a minimum of 3 to 4 brands that I have either shot for or worked with. So promoting that brand becomes a part of my job, because I associate myself only with brands that I relate to. So, you know, introducing them to my Instagram family becomes a part of it. So say if you take a grid of 9, say 3x3, if out of that 5 spots are filled, there are only 4 spots left for dynamic filling. Say whether it's a coffee shot, whether it's a travel shot, whether it's just me chilling at home, whether it's just the light at home. So at this point in our journey, everything is planned beforehand. There is no abhi shoot ki aur abhi dala. Like, there is a lot of effort that goes into content creation and content planning as well.
Right.
So for someone in the field, this isn't just a process, it's a state of mind. It's like an ongoing thing. Also, now you have to be on point with creating content that is valuable and shareable and doable. And then you make a reel out of it, and you have to break it down to the level that anybody seeing it can understand.
Right.
So actually now it's become like having an idea is the easy bit. Converting the idea to a full-blown reel or a DIY post is where the actual discipline and experience comes in. Like, it takes a lot of research and technical know-how to, you know, kind of break down complex things to easier levels. So I would say content creation should, like, if you were to ask me, what can you do better? I think you should research firstly what works for you, what works for your audience. Research is key. And having a basic idea of what you want to post. Maybe you don't have to, you know, do like me and have a 9-day grid ready, but you can do 2 days at a time. So I have usually noticed if it's a post in rush, like if I've just taken a picture and just edited and just posted, it usually ends up being very haphazard, because nothing has been given 50, like, you know, 100%. Like, you have to research what you, hashtag research is a new kind of science nowadays. I think everything on Instagram has become so complicated. So it's not like before where I can just say hashtag coffee and forget it. So I think all of it has kind of evolved. So someone very nicely said to me, so Instagram is not a program. It's an algorithm. So it evolves like you evolve. So if you want to get the best out of it, you kind of have to give your best to it.
Yeah, and besides Instagram, your blog is also very beautiful, and the stories you write on it, they're
so
sweet.
Much.
You know,
it's taken so long, but it's already done. Like, I was so glad we could launch it on my birthday, because that date is special. So, you know, we'll always remember every year that we launched it on that day. and it's taken a lot of effort, but I'm so glad we are we've gone live. And yeah, we are still working back end, but everything else is live. Yeah,
so you are a wonderful writer also, like photography kar lete hain.
Thank you so much.
Styling and everything. And when I read your blog post,
honestly,
your captions,
taking a lot of effort to write, but I can write captions. I'm good at the shorter bit. But when you ask me to write like a blog post, I kind of chalo bhaiya, 5-6 dal dete hain, photo, 2-4 paragraph likh dete. I can put as many pictures as you like, but you ask me to write more than 5 paragraphs at a time, and I think I need a coffee.
Okay, so you know, same is the case with me, and that's why I love my work of social media marketing, because usme bhi mera work caption create karna hota hai. Jab bhi mere paas agar koi long form content ka project aata hai na, to I direct them to someone else. I'm like, nahi, ye mujhse nahi ho payega. I cannot commit to it for long time. So I think we all have different strengths and weaknesses, but the way you write now, it doesn't feel like it, because I think you have the talent for it. It feels very warm, very nice to read.
Thank
bahut,
you
know,
thank
high
you
quality
so
content hota lagta hai kisi magazine ke liye likha hai, but bahut man se likha hai, bahut acche se likha hai. So I really
isliye blog post kam hai na, kyunki itna time lagta hai mujhe likhne mein compared to how many pictures I put up in a week, blog post do hi jaate hai.
Still, at least whatever consistency you can stick to, you are sticking to it and you are doing it nicely. I think this is also one message that everyone needs to hear, ki koi zaruri nahi hai ki aap roj ek blog post dalo ya maybe roj do reel dalo ki Instagram keh raha hai isliye reel dalo. Matlab jo bhi aap kar sakte ho utna hi karo, like give your best to whatever you
can. Yeah, that's true. So if you can't create good content every day, create good content every 3 days, but then do it consistently. Do it every 3 days consistently. ऐसे नहीं कि 3 दिन के बाद डाल दिया फिर 15 दिन बाद डाल.
राइट. सो शर्मिला, जैसे आपने बताया कि आउट ऑफ 9 यू हैव लाइक 4-5 पोस्ट्स स्पॉन्सर्ड. तो अभी क्या होता है कि बहुत सारे लोग स्पॉन्सर्ड पोस्ट देखते हैं, तो दे आर वेरी क्लियर कि ये स्पॉन्सर्ड है, इस पे तो मुझे देखना ही नहीं है, ये तो कोई ना कोई प्रोडक्ट प्रमोट कर रही होगी. बट आपकी फीड पे जाके ऐसा नहीं लगता है, लाइक इट इज वेरी ऑर्गेनिक. तो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ एफर्ट डू यू पुट इन, या व्हाट इज द थॉट प्रोसेस बिहाइंड मेकिंग इट ऑर्गेनिक? हाउ डू यू मेक इट लुक सो नेचुरल?
So at the risk of sounding like a complete snob, I feel like why do you do anything where you have to pretend and make things look a certain way? I think as a creator, as an influencer, as an inspirer, you owe it to your audience to properly vet and deliver only the collaborations that you connect with. So if I do not connect with a certain brand, I, you know, regretfully bow out saying, you know, this is not something I can do. Because honestly, thankfully, I'm grateful for all the work I have. I have more than my share of work. And I am not the kind of people, you know, who like to have everything booked. I am the kind of people who likes to space out my work, because I have a 4-year-old and I'm enjoying every minute as a mother. So for me, it becomes kind of a challenge when I have to shoot every day. I batch shoot. I do not shoot every single day. I love to spend time with family. I love to have days where I do nothing. And I love to spend time with my little one, especially now with the lockdown and no schools. So I feel like to make collabs look organic, you know, that was your question, how to make them look organic. I think the best way to do that for a creator is to actually relate with the brand, to relate with the concept, to relate with the product. If I do not relate with something, I do not do it only for the money. And I think that's why you cannot probably see that they are sponsored on my feed. I have had the good fortune of working with brands, a lot of them women, 85 to 90% of them women, small businesses, big businesses, whatever, who are incredible in their fields. And at no point have I had to compromise on my aesthetic, or have I ever had to kind of say ki nahi ye acha nahi hai par fir bhi post kar deti hu kyunki brand ke liye. So I feel it's a very big responsibility for you as a influencer to kind of put up content that or kind of put up brands that you would buy from, or that you would not mind supporting.
Yeah, true. Well, because when I started out as an influencer, I started in 2018, like not influencer influencer I started as a blogger who used to share funny quotes and things like that. So jab maine start kiya tha na, there was this rush of getting followers, collaborations. Like there was this rush of getting collaborations. Everyone is getting collaborations. Us waqt mom blogging ka field was there and I used to see bigger bloggers. Jo meri friends thi, we were all on the same level, around 1000 or so followers. और हम लोग को लगता था यार उसको कोलैबोरेशन मिल गया, मुझे नहीं मिला. तो ये फीलिंग इतनी आती थी. और इस चीज को समझने में, इससे बाहर आने में, इट टुक मी माय फ्रेंड्स सम टाइम, लाइक एटलीस्ट अ ईयर और मे बी इवन मोर देन दैट, अ बिट मोर देन दैट, समझ में आने में. लेकिन आई थिंक द क्लैरिटी यू हैव, इट इज व्हाट इज डूइंग वंडर्स फॉर योर वर्क एंड इट रिफ्लेक्ट्स व्हाट एवर यू डू.
Honestly, to tell you, even I did all this mom blogging thing. And I remember that stage where I used to be at 3,000, I was, I think, 3,000, 3,500. And I think 90% of them were friends and family. And so I remember these first grand all used to have collabs then. And to be honest, even at that point in my career, there was no career also that time. It was just a hobby. Even at that point in my social media journey, I did not do those collabs, even if they came. Because there came a point where I said, you know, I am not going to do what 10 other bloggers are doing, because they would have the same concept na. Sabko wo talcum powder ki bottle khadi karni hoti thi, you know, whatever whatever their concept was, they all had to do. They would have 10 top bloggers doing the same thing. So honestly, even Instagram has evolved a lot since then, like since when we are talking about. So even then I didn't do those. I said, dude, hum se na ho payega, I'm not doing this. Like, it's okay if I don't get the followers, but that's why I didn't do very well in the mom blogging field, and I kind of didn't enjoy it as much.
Yeah, क्योंकि उसमें होता क्या है कि एक ही ब्रांड की एक ही पोस्ट एक ही दिन में सब ब्लॉगर्स पोस्ट कर देते हैं, तो योर फीड इज फिल्ड विद द सेम प्रोडक्ट एंड यू आर लाइक, अच्छा सब लोग प्रमोट कर रहे हैं, मतलब दे आर गेटिंग पेड फॉर इट, तो मतलब प्रोडक्ट इज नॉट दैट ग्रेट.
तब ये नहीं पता था, अब पता है.
हाँ, इनिशियली नहीं,
मुझे तो नहीं पता. When you're talking about 2018, 2019, all this was fairly new that time.
So, but we have grown with it, and you.
Oh
have
yeah,
grown with it.
And we've learned from it.
We have learned from it, and now you connect very nicely with your followers. So, we would like to know how to connect with our followers, like how to build trust, how to connect with them in such a way that हम जो भी बोल रहे हैं, it's not just about pushing a product या फिर promoting a product.
Correct.
It's also about connecting on with every post या with every story, with every caption. So, how do you connect with your followers? How do you build trust?
The easiest and the most honest answer I can give you is be true to yourself. You be you. So the minute you start pretending to be someone else, there is going to be a point that will come wherein nakab utar jaye. So you know, wo consistency nahi rehti hai. So you have to be you, whatever you are. You don't koi doodh ka dulha nahi hota. So it's just everybody goes through depression, everybody goes through lows, everybody goes through highs, everybody has happy moments, everybody has coffee. So whatever it is that you do in life, just be you, and it's the best way to kind of create a brand for yourself, because they associate you with that. So if you look at my feed, it's all about minimalism, it's all about clean whites, it's about aesthetics, it's about motherhood, it's about of course, it's about my work, but along with all these things, there are these, you know, nuggets of me as a person. Yes. Like, that's, I had put up a post a few days ago about humanizing your feed. So, what happens to a lot of product photographer feeds is they get lost in the product photography. So, that's why I'm not just a photographer, I'm also a lifestyle blogger. Because I love to share things about my everyday. I love to share things about where we travel. I love to share things about what Leo did. Or, you know, it's all about consistency as well as transparency. I'm often asked, you know, how I manage to reply to every comment or every DM. Honestly, it's not that hard if you try. If the other person is taking the time to actually stop on your, you know, picture, give it a like, put a sweet comment, use kind words. I think the least I can do is, you know, just get to know their name and leave a thank you. Like, thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting, or, you know, thank you for being a part of our journey. Also, endorsing the right kind of products and brands is a big part of building that trust. Because a lot of people, I don't know, good or bad, whether it's a good thing or a bad thing, follow you blindly when it comes to the brand pushing that you do. Mm-hmm. So if you are pushing brands just for the sake of money, initially you might just get away with it, but eventually people are going to realize. So if you want to do this as a way of life and not just a short-term goal, I think you should, rethink endorsing the right kind of content. Mm-hmm. Also, things like doing the Q&As, it also gives people a sneak peek into your life. Like, they understand there is a person behind this sincere storyteller. It's not just a name or it's not just a photographer. She's a mother, she's a friend, she's a daughter. She has lows like you. She needs her coffee in the morning before she... So it's a person. It's a human being beyond, all the facade, all the clean feed. Yes, I'm a creature of habit. I am intensely planned, but that wasn't like this before I had a child. I think motherhood kind of flipped that switch in me, wherein micromanaging and planning has become a part of my life. Mm-hmm. Because if I want to give my 100% at both the avenues in my life, I kind of think I need to plan. There are a lot of people who can wing it, but I am not one of those people.
Mm-hmm. True.
So I think mostly just being kind, and I think kindness is a great virtue to have, and I think it takes you a long way. So it's okay to not have as many followers, but if you have the kind of followers that are kind to you, or that are supporting you in everything you do, I think I would be more than happy mm-hmm. being where I am.
Yeah. So, Sharmila, you are a wonderful photographer. You are a storyteller. So, before we wind up this episode, we would like to know your 5 tips for storytelling through pictures. Because hum log zyadatar sabhi Instagram pe hain, and Instagram is a very visual medium. So, Instagram pe, pictures ke through, how can we tell stories that connect with people?
Okay, so this is one question everybody who meets me asks now. Mm-hmm. It's like, how to up your Instagram view. So, mm-hmm. so for me, honestly, okay, no one expects every creator to be an expert photographer. That's a given. Like, okay, everybody can't be a photographer. But if you want to do anything on Instagram, you have to have the basic knowledge of photo composition or editing or tools required for editing. Or I would just say invest in a good camera also. But people would, kind of... take offense to that and say iPhone does. So whatever works for you, I think basic knowledge of photography is very, very important if you want to have or build any kind of brand on Instagram. Because Instagram is a photo medium. So even if someone has written beautiful caption, it's like it's going to get tears in your eyes, but the picture doesn't appeal to you, you're going to scroll past it.
Yeah.
So your caption only supports your image, but your image is the first thing that draws your audience in.
Mm-hmm.
And the same thing applies to your feed. So when someone sees, suppose my picture gets featured in the Explore. So when a follower comes from the Explore feed to my page, if they see only that one good picture and baki sab kachra around it, they are not going to end up following you.
Yeah.
But when they see from that picture that entire feed looks like that, that's when they start looking at each feed. And when they start looking at each post, that's when they start reading each post. So captioning and writing comes way lower on the scale when it comes to Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to blogging, it's an entirely different thing. You can hire a photographer or you can choose to not have images on your blog. Mm-hmm. But if you want to do anything in Instagram, I think it's very, very important to have the basic knowledge of photography.
Mm-hmm.
Things like rules of third or composition or lighting. So YouTube also has a lot of courses on how to compose your images, how to edit your images, how to use natural light, or how to just basically up your photography. Mm-hmm. So I would suggest, this is my top tip, like number one, if you ask me to do 5, so this is always going to be number one when you ask me.
Mm-hmm.
Second, I feel that learning to switch it up is very important. Like, I don't know if you've seen feeds of people who have the same thing over and over again. Like, it'll just be pictures of them over and over again, or picture of the dog over and over again.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel giving variety, like say, maybe a picture of you, then a picture of your dog, then maybe you having coffee, then you with your dog, you on the beach, your dog playing. I think it's very important to give a kind of variety in content. Like, not every picture on your feed, even if you're a fashion blogger, should be about you. It can be your hand, it can be your feet, it can be your bag, it can be your dress. It doesn't always have to be you.
Okay.
Am I making sense? Like, is that, I'm trying to...
Yeah, I understand. Because ye bhi storytelling ka ek part hai na, ki stories ke bahut sare bits hote hain. Toh aap apne feed ke through ek story sunane ki koshish kar rahe ho, ki ye sab cheeze mere life ka ek part hai.
Correct. Learning to switch it up in terms of technical aspects, like flat lays or still life or depth of field where the background is blurred or panned out images, all of that also makes a big difference on your feed.
Okay.
And I think aesthetics in general play an important role. If you want to draw audience in and convert them into followers, a feed aesthetic is very important. It doesn't have to be light and airy and caramel like me. It can be dark and moody if you want. Whatever your personality is, I think should reflect in your feed. And the last point I would like to end on is make sure your images kind of emulate the feelings you wish to convey. Like if you're talking about, say, birthday in your caption, then let your image have a cake. Or if you're talking about, say, motherhood in today's post, let your child or some kind of something related to motherhood be a part of the picture. Or if you're talking about, say, gardening, let there be plants or gardening tools in your picture. Let what you're talking and what you're putting up be related. Sometimes what happens is people put up a picture of the sea and they're talking about something completely different.
Yeah.
So I think those are the top five things that I would suggest. Like if you are going to want to tell stories through your photographs, I think these are the five things that I would suggest that you should invest in.
Yeah. So last point that you mentioned, it is very important because as you said, it is very common to have unrelated pictures and captions. Kai bar hota hai, log kuch bhi photo dal denge. Ho sakta hai picture happy ho, but they are talking.
I'm like, what? Like, I don't even understand how, like, from where it went to where, and pictures not related at all. Like, thoda to, it doesn't have to, like, completely be a photo shoot, but it should be a little related to what you're talking about.
Yeah. I think it happens when people post just for the sake of posting because they have pictures but they don't have anything to say. So, kuch bhi
but that's when the content planning helps. Like, if your content is planned ahead, then you don't have to face all this. And I'm not saying that every single day has to be planned. So, if we have a little time, do we have a little time?
Yeah.
So, if I say I do a grid of 9, out of that, 5 are decided. And 4 are dynamic posts that I have the content for, but I don't plan it ahead saying, ye din pe yehi jayega. Ki this day, if I wake up and I feel like I want to talk about, Syria, it goes on the feed. It doesn't have to be like, ki aaj coffee ka hai, to aaj coffee jaane chahiye. Aisa kuch hard and fast nahi. It's a dynamically rotating field, wherein if tomorrow I think, this brand feed is not going to do well on a Sunday, I want to push it to a Monday. I can do that and still have something to post on Sunday. It's just the planning wherein everything is ready to go. You can switch it up. Or you can be spontaneous and ask, suppose I decide to go for a run and find a really beautiful frame. I have provision in my planning to include that. It's not that abhi are aaj ka post to yehi hai to yehi karna. It's not like that. But it just helps you to have a better idea and not put up content that we just discussed. Like photo hai par caption kuch aur hi hai. Like so planning kind of helps you. Also now Instagram has become very, very, very difficult in terms of everything has to be of value. Everything has to be something people will share. Otherwise, nobody is going to engage on it.
Yes.
So as compared to what Instagram was when I started out, now it's a completely different ballgame. Like, I think it's evolving by the minute and it's getting even more smarter in terms of delivering content to its users. It's getting very difficult for the creators, incredibly enhanced for the users.
True. So I think, Sharmila, you need to later or maybe in future have some courses for people ki photography kaise achhi kare, apni feed ko kaise maintain.
Yeah, that's on the list. Yes.
I
think the day
it.
I decide ki bas baba ho gaya, ye sara ho gaya sab, jhol chal jo karna tha, ab next kya kare, so that's definitely on the list. Maybe a few years down the line, but so I have decided to do a course when I'm done learning myself. So the day I think that I have learned enough and I have gained enough to be able to share with others is the day I think I'll announce a course. अभी तो जर्नी चालू हुई है, अभी तो बहुत सीखना है.
अभी तो बहुत सीखना है. या ओके सो शर्मिला, वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट योर इंस्टाग्राम हैंडल, सिंस यू आर स्टोरी टेलर, सो इट इज द बेस्ट वे टू कनेक्ट विद यू, राइट?
Yes, you can even connect with me via the email. There is a subscribe link where you can drop in your whatever you want to write, or you can DM me on Instagram. These are the best ways because I check them every single day, and I might not have replied, but I am getting to it because the amount of DMs and emails that I have to reply to are incredible. But trust me, I work on them every single night, so I do reply to them.
Okay, so connect with Sharmila on Sincere Storyteller. Check out her feed. It is amazing. You will love it and you will learn a lot from it. So Sharmila, thank you so much for being on Little Fixes and sharing your learnings with my listeners.
Thank you so much for having me, Maitri. This was amazing. It was like talking to a friend. Honestly, I didn't know how the time has passed. It's been a while, but I didn't realize you've been amazing. Thank you so much.
तो कुछ लोग ऐसे होते हैं जिनसे जब आप पहली बार ही बात करते हो, आपको समझ में आ जाता है कि ये जेन्युइन लोग हैं, जो ये बात कर रहे हैं ये इन्होंने एक्चुअली में किया हुआ है, इसको फील करके बता रहे हैं. और शर्मिला इज वन ऑफ दोज पीपल. मुझे उनसे बात करके बहुत अच्छा लगा और जो भी उन्होंने मैसेजेस शेयर किए वो सबके लिए रेलेवेंट हैं. और अगर आपको लगता है कि आपकी हेल्प हुई है तो डोंट फॉरगेट टू शेयर दिस एपिसोड विद 3 ऑफ योर फ्रेंड्स और मे बी फैमिली मेम्बर्स जिनको इससे हेल्प मिल सकती है, जिनको स्टक फील हो रहा है और मे बी एपिसोड के मैसेजेस जो शर्मिला ने दिए हैं वो उनके काम आ सकते हैं. तो डू शेयर इट विद योर फ्रेंड्स एंड फैमिली, मे बी शेयर इट ऑन सोशल मीडिया, टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट एंड शेयर इट ऑन सोशल मीडिया, टैग @LittleFixesPodcast एंड @SincereStoryteller. साथ ही हमारे एपिसोड को सब्सक्राइब कर सकते हैं आपके फेवरेट पॉडकास्ट प्लेटफॉर्म पे. एंड येस, इफ यू आर ऑन एप्पल पॉडकास्ट, गूगल पॉडकास्ट, जहां भी हैं, हमें रेट रिव्यू करना मत भूलिए बिकॉज इट हेल्प्स द पॉडकास्ट रीच मोर पीपल. जो हमारे मैसेजेस हैं पॉजिटिविटी के वो और ज्यादा वुमेन की हेल्प कर सकते हैं. Okay, now it's time to wrap up today's episode. और हम लोग मिलेंगे next Wednesday with a brand new episode with some brand new ideas. तो फिर next Wednesday का wait करो और सदा sassy रहो. Bye.